So we've completed two of the three layers on our Rubik's Cube. In this video, I'll teach you the first half of the last layer solution, which is known as orienting the last layer. You'll see what that means shortly. So notice that once we get to the last layer, we can't really do anything except turn the top layer without messing up any pieces that we've already solved. So we're very restricted in what moves we can do, and so we will require the use of algorithms to solve the last layer. So we're now going to solve the last layer in four steps. The first of these steps is what we call edge orientation. So here, what we essentially want to do is to solve the cross on the yellow layer. However, this is slightly different to the cross we solved in step one, in that we don't need the pieces to match up along the side, we just need the yellow cross on top. When orienting your edges, you'll either have one of four possible cases. So this first case, your edges will already be solved, so there's no need for you to do anything. The next case we'll look at is if you have two edges oriented and they're opposite from one another. So what we'll do to form the cross in this case is hold them so that they're the left and the right positions and perform the following algorithm. F, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime, and then your cross will be solved on the top. The next case we'll look at is if you have two edges oriented, but they're adjacent to one another on the top layer. In this case, you'll hold them so that they're at the back and the left positions and perform the following algorithm twice. So it's the same algorithm as before, but you're just going to do it two times instead. So F, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime, and now you have the case where the edges are opposite one another, so you'll just do the algorithm again from this angle. F, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime, and now you've got the cross solved. The last case is where you have zero edges oriented, and so all you need to do is, from any angle, just perform the algorithm that I showed you before. F, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime. And now you'll have the case where the edges are adjacent. So what you do, remember, is holding it in the back and the left, like so, perform the algorithm twice. F, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime, then you have the line, and one more time. F, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime. And then you've got the cross. So those are all the four cases for edge orientation. Now we're going to show you how to orient the corners of your last layer. So now that we've oriented the edges of our last layer, we need to orient the corners of our last layer to make the entire top face a yellow color. Again, there'll be four different cases for the corners. So the first case is that your corners are already solved, in which case you don't need to do anything at all and you move on to the next step. The next case is if you have one corner oriented on top. So in this case, it's this one. What you need to do is to hold the cube such that this corner is in the front left position and perform the following algorithm. Now, you'll need to do this either once or twice, depending on which case you have. But in either case, you need to just hold the corner so that it's in the front left position, like so. And then the algorithm goes R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime, and you'll have oriented the corners of your top layer. So that was the easy case where you have one corner oriented. Now let's look at a case where you have two corners oriented, which is slightly more difficult. So what you do, if you see that there are two corners oriented on your cube on the last layer, you need to hold the cube so that there's a yellow sticker in the front left position. So rotate the cube to find the angle where there's a yellow sticker right here. No, that's orange. No, that's red. Here, yellow, facing towards you in the left. And then all you need to do is perform the algorithm that I showed you before. R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime. And now you have a case where there's only one corner oriented. So, as before, you need to hold it in the front left and perform the same algorithm again. R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime. And like I said before, you'll either need to do that algorithm once or twice in the case where you have one corner oriented. In this case, we need to do it twice. So again, we have one corner oriented. We need to hold it so that it's in the front left position, like that, and then go again. R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime. Now you've solved the top base. The last case we can have is where there are no corners oriented on our top layer. So we need to do something similar to the case where we had two corners oriented, but slightly different. So we need to rotate the cube so that there's a yellow sticker in the front left position facing outwards or to the left. So previously when there were two corners oriented on top, we looked for the yellow sticker here. Now we want a yellow sticker in this position right here, which we have found. So then perform the following algorithm. R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime. And as before, you have the case where there's now one corner oriented on top. So holding it in the front left position and perform the same algorithm again. R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime. There you go. Now that we've oriented all of our pieces on top, what we need to do now is move them into their correct positions.